Hello everyone and welcome back to my lecture series. I am Dr. Prerna, Assistant Professor at All India Shri Shivaji Memorial Society, College of Hotel Management and Catering Technology, Pune. Today's topic, that is Principles of Cleaning, is covered under Program BSc Hospitality Studies, Class First Year, Course HS203 Housekeeping Operations, Semester 2, Chapter 1, Cleaning Routine of Housekeeping Department. Course outcome for this semester are Understand Role of Housekeeping in Hospitality Industry. Second course outcome is Study Basic Skills for Different Tasks and Aspects in Housekeeping. Learn operational aspects like cleaning routine of housekeeping department. And the fourth course outcome is understand various procedural aspects of cleaning public areas. The learning outcome for today's session are understand the concept of cleaning. And the second outcome is know principles of cleaning. Before starting the session, we'll first of all know what is cleaning. Cleaning is the removal of dust, dirt, foreign matters, tarnish, and stain from various surfaces with the aid of certain cleaning equipment and cleaning agents. Dust, dirt, and foreign matter deposited on the surface areas are referred as soil. Cleaning is important, and that's why there are different reasons to carry out cleaning in the premises. First one is aesthetic appeal. The environment is made visually attractive and appealing. Hygiene. Effective frequent cleaning controls the growth and reproduction of bacteria and other germs. Maintenance. Surface and article, however good in quality, will have a long functional life only when they are cleaned on regular basis. And the last reason for cleaning is safety. Safety is done for safety against health hazards, fire hazards, and slip hazards. Principles of cleaning are the basic rules to follow in any kind of cleaning activity, whatever the nature of the surface or the type of soil. These are the rules that we have to keep it in mind wherever we are doing a cleaning process. So let's begin with the principles of cleaning. All soils should be removed. This is a basic principle. Wherever we are doing a cleaning process, we have to consider that where the type of soil or the type of surface which is there, we have to remove all soil before starting with the cleaning process. Soil should be removed without harming the surface. We have to keep this thing in mind whenever we are doing a cleaning process or whenever we are removing the soil from the surface area, so we don't have to harm the surface and the surrounding area of the surface. The surface should be restored to its original state after the cleaning process. Next principle of cleaning is the cleaning process should be efficient using minimum of cleaning equipment, cleaning agent, labor, and time. Whichever cleaning process you are following, you have to use a minimum number of equipment. That means you have to select a cleaning equipment which can perform multiple tasks so that you can reduce the number of equipment, that is minimum of equipment. Cleaning agent, you have to select a cleaning agent that will perform more than one task, and labor you have to select, or you have to tell your skilled staff to do the cleaning process, so that you can invest less amount of time in that particular cleaning process. So that's why the cleaning process should be efficient, using minimum of equipments, cleaning agent, labor and time. The simplest method we have to use first, using the mildest cleaning agent. You don't have to rush towards the hardest cleaning method and the strongest cleaning agent. You have to first of all use the very simple method for doing a cleaning process with the use of mild cleaning agent. The cleaning method least harmful for the surface should be removed using cleaning process from high to low wherever possible. That means you have to follow certain method or the cleaning method that will least harmful for the surface area, and you have to start your cleaning process starting from the high point to the low point. For example, if you want to clean a room, so you can start your cleaning from cleaning the ceiling area first, and then the wall, and then the last will be floor area. So you will follow the process from high to low wherever it is possible. Next principle of cleaning is, when we are doing a cleaning, we have to start the process with the clean surface area and the article, and then we can go to the heavy soiled one area, so that we can prevent the clean area spread of the soil from dirty to the cleaner surface. While wet cleaning or polishing of the floor, the cleaner should walk backward while cleaning will happen in front of the person. For example, if we are doing a cleaning, or if we are doing a mopping area or polishing of the floor, that time the person who is performing the cleaning process, he will walk backward, and the clean surface will be visible in front of him. So whenever we are doing a mopping or whenever we are doing a polishing of the floor, that time we have to walk backward, and the cleaning will happen and the cleaning is visible in front of the cleaner. Suction cleaning should be preferred over sweeping wherever possible. Suction cleaning means the vacuum cleaning. Wherever possible, if it is possible, as per the area or as per the surface, we have to prefer the vacuum cleaning over the sweeping. Next principle of cleaning is, sweeping should be done before dusting and dusting before suction cleaning. This means that if we are using a broom, that is a manual cleaning equipment, for sweeping the surface area, that time we have to follow this sequence. We have to follow the sequence such as sweeping, dusting and mopping. So that means we have to first of all do sweeping, second will be dusting, and the third one will be mopping. But if we are using a vacuum cleaner, as in suction, we are following the suction cleaning process, that time we have to follow the sequence. First of all, we'll do dusting, and then we'll do suction cleaning. So if we are using a broom, so the sequence will be sweeping, dusting and mopping. And if we are using a vacuum cleaner, then dusting, the sequence will be dusting and suction cleaning. Next principle is, we have to keep noise level as possible, because it might happen that wherever you are doing a cleaning process, the noise that you are creating during the cleaning process, maybe it is because of the machine, or maybe it's because of the manual cleaning equipment that you are using. So the guest may get disturbed because of such noise. So the most this principle is based on the noise level that you are creating during the cleaning process. So noise level should be kept as low as possible. Next principle is stains should be removed as soon as they occur. So if small stains that you have that is occurred on the surface area, so you have to remove as soon as they occurred, and you can do a spot cleaning as a primary action so that it will help you to remove the stain more easily. Another principle is the cleaner should take all safety precautions while cleaning. In particular, cleaning agent and equipment should be stacked neatly to one side. Now, health and safety of the person who is performing the cleaning process is very important. So it is the responsibility of a staff and the cleaner who is performing the cleaning process that he should take all necessary precautions regarding the safety. So he should wear a protective clothing that includes apron, non-slippery shoes, and if he is handling hazardous cleaning equipments or hazardous cleaning agents and heavy equipment, so that time he should wear the protective clothing, and he should wear the protective gears also. For example, if he is handling cleaning hazardous cleaning agent, that time he should wear gloves and protective eyewears. If he is handling heavy equipment, so non-slippery shoes and proper electric fitting. All these necessary things that he should keep it in mind regarding the safety precautions. And while storing the cleaning equipments and cleaning agent, he should follow the proper storage procedure for cleaning equipment and cleaning agent. The cleaner should start cleaning from the farthest end of an area, working towards the exit. So if let's consider a room where the cleaner is starting with the cleaner is started with the cleaning process, so he should start with the farthest end of the area, that is the last corner of the that particular area, and working towards the exit, that means at the exit door. Next principle: after the cleaning process is over, all equipment should be washed or wiped as applicable, dried and stored properly. Cleaning agent should be replenished and stored, waste discarded, and area left neat and tidy. So after the cleaning process is done, the cleaner should clean the equipment, wash it properly, dry it properly, and store in the designated areas. The cleaning agent should be replenished and store properly as per the storage procedure for cleaning agent. They should label it whatever the cleaning agent name, and everything should be visible. Then he should wipe the rim of the cleaning agent container so that there should be no spillage occurs at the on the floor. Whatever waste that is collected during the cleaning process, that should be discarded as per the discard management system followed by the company, and the area should left neat and tidy. I hope you understood the various principles of cleaning that we have to follow during the cleaning process. For more reference, the reference are mentioned in front of your screen. Thank you for your patience listening. Don't forget to attempt the quiz. The quiz link is mentioned in the description box. Thank you once again.